Very good morning, Aitra students. Today I am going to explain new chapter, that is direct and inverse proportion. So before going to topic, just listen one example. The cost of one ball is 5 rupees. Cost of one ball is 5 rupees. Cost of two balls, 10 rupees. Cost of three balls, 15 rupees. Then cost of four balls, 20 rupees. Cost of five balls, 25 rupees. Here, what did you observe here? See, number of balls are increasing and also cost of that balls are also increasing. Here both quantities, like balls are one quantity and their cost are another quantity. Here both quantities are increasing. See, cost of one ball is 5 rupees, cost of two balls 10 rupees, cost of three balls 15 rupees, cost of four balls 20. Here number of balls are increasing along with cost of the balls are also increasing. Now take another example. Cost of 10 pence 100 rupees. Cost of 10 pence 100 rupees. Then cost of 9 pence 90 rupees. Cost of 8 pence 80 rupees. Cost of 7 pence 70 rupees. Here number of pence are decreasing and also cost of that pence are also decreasing. In these two examples, both quantities are increasing and both quantities are decreasing. If one quantity increases, another quantity is also increases. If one quantity decreases, another quantity also decreases. This type of proportion is called a direct proportion. Both quantities will increase or decrease. Okay. Along with one quantity, another one also increase or decrease. If one quantity increases, another also increase. If one quantity decreases, another also decreases. See here. If x and y are any two quantities, like balls and that cost, such that both of them increase or decrease together, and x by y, ratio of that quantities same, then we say that x and y are in direct proportion. This can be written as x directly proportional to y. X directly proportional to y, and read as x directly proportional to y. We can say x proportional to y, then x is equal to k. K is nothing but constant term. X by y is equal to k. Ratio of x and y remains same, remains constant. Okay, what is direct proportion in? What is the direct proportion in two quantities? If one quantity decrease, another also decrease. If one quantity increase, another also increase. So this type of proportion is called a direct proportion. Here x and y are two quantities. If both increase or decrease together, then we can say x and x directly proportional to y. If y1 and y2 are the values of y corresponding to the values of x1 and x2 of x, then we can say x1 by x2 is equal to y1 by y2. Here is the first problem in the chapter. If the cost of 65 tea packets, the cost of 65 tea packets 2600. What is the cost of 75 tea packets? Here what is the given? The cost of 65 tea packets is 2600. Then we have to find the cost of 75 tea packets. We know that if number of packets increases, in previous day I gave an example, cost of one ball 5 rupees, cost of two balls 10 rupees, balls are increasing, their cost is also increasing. Similarly here, if packets increase, cost also increase. Then we know that if number of packets increases, then the cost also increase. Then X means I am taking as tea packets. Y means their cost. Tea packets. The cost of 65 tea packets is 2600. Then what is the cost of 75 tea packets? So according to formula, what we can write here? X1 by X2 is equal to Y1 by, sorry, X1 by Y1 is equal to X2 by Y2. X1 is nothing but cost of tea packets, sorry, X is nothing but number of tea packets, Y is nothing but cost. X1 by Y1 is equal to X2 by Y2. What is the meaning of X1? 65 by 2600 is equal. Whatever X2? 75. By here I don't know. Let that is K. By K. Now I am doing cross multiplication. K into 65 is equal to 75 into 2600. Then K is equal to 75 into 2600 by 65. Now any calculations? Come on. 5 1s are. Next 5 3s are. 5 1s are, 5 2 remains. 5 5s are. 13 1s are, 13 2s are. How much? 3000. The cost of 75 tea packets is 3000. So cost of here, what is the given? Cost of 65 tea packets is 2600. You have to find the cost of 75 tea packets. So after the calculation, the cost of 75 tea packets is 3000. Cost of 75 tea packets is equal to 3000 rupees. So here is the next question. If a pipe can fill tank of capacity 50 liters in 1 hour, so the pipe will take 5 hours time to fill the 50 liters tank. Then how long it will take to fill the tank of capacity 75 liters? Here first 50 liters, next 75 liters. Here capacity of the tank is increased. If the capacity of the tank increases, filling time is also increased. So both are in direct proportion. See here, capacity of tank to fill the 50 liters tank, it was taking 5 hours time to fill the 75 liters. So both are in direct proportion. What we can write here? X1 by X1 by Y1 is equal to X2 by Y2. What about the X1 here? 50 liters by 5 is equal to 75 by k, and doing cross multiplication. 50 into k is equal to 75 into 5. Then k is equal to 75 into 5 by 50. 5 1s are, 5 10s are. 5 2s are, 5 15s are. K is equal to 15 by 2. It is nothing but 7. Okay. 7 and a half hours. So 7 hours 30 minutes. So to fill the 75 liters tank, it was taking 7 hours 30 minutes time. 48 bags of padding cost 16,800. So here the cost of 48 bags is 16,800. Then you have to find the cost of 36 bags. See here. The cost of 48 bags is 16,800. Then you have to find the cost of 36 bags. Let the cost of 36 bags is K. Here, number of bags are decreased. So, cost has also decreased. So, both are in direct proportion. What we can write here? X1 by Y1 is equal to X2 by Y2. What about the X1 here? 48 by 16,800 is equal to 36 by k. I am doing cross multiplication. So k is equal to 36 into 16,800 by 48. Any cancellation here? See, 6 8s are 48, 6 6 are 36. Next, 2 3s are, 2 4s are, 4 4s are, 4 2s are, and 0 0. 0 3 0 0 3 2 6 3 4 7.
So
cost of 36 bags is 12,600 rupees. Here is the homework and today's class. If the cost of 20 meters cloth is 1600, then what is the cost of 25 meters cloth? If the cost of 20 rice bags of the same size is 20,000, what is the cost of 30 such bags?